Mike, only now the problem mystery is that someone who start losing more than 3.5 grams proteins per day into urine, plasma protein levels start going down in spite of contributory synthesis of, compensatory synthesis of 10 to 12 grams per liver. If someone can answer, fine, otherwise I'm left with the answer.
Most of the rest of the proteins will be bound to all the molecules.
Okay, before you come up with the very new theory, which no one knows, let me explain. Right? So, actually, the real loss from here is not 3.5 gram. Here are your friends, proximal convoluted tubular cells. And they love to eat up the proteins. The proteins which are leaking down, many of them by pinocytic process are taken up into these cells. Which cells? Cells of? Proximal convoluted tubule. And lot of proteins are catabolized there. So whenever extra proteins are lost from the blood to the Bowman space, right, only some proteins appear into urine and a lot is destroyed in the proximal convoluted tubule. And this is a loss you are not concentrating on. Proximal convoluted tubules are concerned with the metabolism of, rather catabolism of small molecular weight proteins. Is that right? So naturally, when there's no protein leakage, no significant losses here, no significant catabolism here. But as soon as there's a disease which damages the glomerular structure, a lot of proteins start leaking down. Maybe total protein is leaking 14 grams. Out of that 14 grams, maybe 5 grams come down here and 9 grams are destroyed here. Is that right? So basically, there are two types of losses of the proteins which are pathologically filtered from glomerular barrier into Bowman space. Some of the protein really appears into urine and some of protein is catabolized in proximal convoluted tubule. Is that clear to everyone? Right? So what really happens, once there is heavy proteinuria is a term to be used when protein losses in the urine are more than 3.5 gram. When you have a heavy proteinuria, then you start developing hypoalbuminemia. What you start developing? Hypoproteinemia. Of course, plasma proteins will be less, albumin will be less, and globulin will be less if it is non-selective protein losses. When plasma protein levels goes down, plasma proteins do a lot of function. One of the very important function is that plasma proteins maintain the osmotic pressure or oncotic pressure within the circulatory system. Plasma proteins maintain the osmotic pressure within the circulatory system. Right? You know that hydrostatic pressure, for example, this is an artery. Here is a capillary network, and here is the vein. Now what really happens? Hydrostatic pressure is pushing the fluid out into interstitial area. Hydrostatic pressure is pushing the fluid out. And osmotic pressure exerted by the plasma protein is pulling the fluid in. Is that right? So, capillaries on their arterial end, capillaries, when they are on the arterial end, hydrostatic pressure is more. Hydrostatic pressure is more than the osmotic pressure of proteins. So fluid leaks out. But as blood moves from arterial end of the capillary to the venous end of the capillaries, hydrostatic pressure drop. And within this part of the capillary, osmotic pressure is more than the hydrostatic pressure. So fluid which has gone to interstitial area, it is sucked back. So this is a normal mechanism that in every tissue, normally, constantly, from arterial side of the capillaries, fluid is leaking out, adding to interstitial fluid, and fluid on the venous end of the capillaries, fluid is constantly taken back to the circulatory system due to high osmotic pressure. Again, listen. Osmotic pressure of protein in most of the capillaries is around 27 millimeter of mercury. But hydrostatic pressure here is 40, and here it is maybe 15. So along the capillary length, it is the hydrostatic pressure which mainly changes. In the beginning of the capillaries, hydrostatic pressure is more than osmotic pressures or oncotic pressure. At the end of the capillaries, hydrostatic pressure is less than the oncotic pressure of proteins. So what really happens? That all the capillaries on their arterial ends, they are allowing the fluid to go out to take the oxygen, carbon dioxide, glucose, amino acids, and many things to the cells. And on the venous ends of the capillaries, right, fluid is coming back to circulatory system, right, to bringing the waste product. So what's really happening all over your body? That in every tissue, fluid is coming out of capillaries, washing the cells, giving service to the cells, providing the nutrients, removing the waste product, going back from the venous end of the capillaries. Am I clear? Now, in our patient, there's significant injury to the glomerular structures and they have been heavy proteinuria, and due to heavy proteinuria, patient develop hypoproteinemia, and when proteins level becomes significantly low, then osmotic pressure in the capillaries becomes so less that on the arterial end of the capillaries, extra fluid is leaking out, and on the venous end of the capillary, reclaiming of the fluid by the circulatory system is poor. So excessive fluid accumulate in interstitial spaces, and that adds to the situation which is called edema. And because this happens all over the body, we call it generalized edema. And severe generalized edema is called anasarca. Severe generalized edema is called anasarca. So you understand that after heavy proteinuria, you develop hypoproteinemia, especially hypoalbuminemia, and that clinically translates into what? Generalized edema. A special point. Edema of the renal system, especially edema which developed due to protein losing nephropathies, initially start around the eyes and then face. Then it spreads over all the body. So we say edema of renal origin usually start or initiate as periorbital edema. And later on it will become all over the body, and this edema will be more in the dependent part of the body. Why it starts, why it is more in the periorbital region? Raise your hand, who can tell me? Mechanism of edema, you know that there is less osmotic pressure due to low plasma proteins, so fluid is excessively lost from vascular compartment to interstitial compartment, and edema is developing all over the body. Who will tell me why in periorbital area edema is more? Answer is very simple. Have you heard of this thing or never heard? You must have heard somewhere, or you will hear that renal edema, if someone patient come and he say daily in the morning when wake up there's too much swelling around the eyes and then on face, you must start suspecting, or you have to rule out the urinary losses of proteins. Okay, let me tell you, actually tissue here is very loose, skin is very poorly attached with the underlying tissue, you know, you can take it up, right? But can you take skin from here up? You cannot. Here it is tightly held. So if capillaries are leaking here, can they build